Hello guys, and welcome to this session where you will learn how to set up autotiling in the Godot engine. This session will cover how to set up 45 degree slopes and also 22.5 degree slopes to make things easy for you when you're building your levels. So let's start by opening up the Godot engine here. I have prepared a simple project and I click on edit. The only thing I prepared is just a tile set in advance and a main node. You're going to click on scene, new scene, click on 2D scene, and rename this to cave tile map. Right click on the node, click change type, search for tile map, click on that and click on change. Then continue by clicking here on tile set, then new tile set. And click tile set. Next, I will drag in my tile set. So click on this, then click edit, and then click on new auto tile. The first thing you have to do is to set the region. So start by clicking on the enable snap and show grid, and lay out your grid on your tile set. Next, click on bit mask. I will zoom this in a bit. Then click here on selected tile and change this from autotile bit mask to 3x3 minimal. And we will now paint. Now click on save. I will put it in my tile sets here. I will rename this to cave tile set auto tile and click on save. So let's try this one first. I will change the icon as well and set it to be this one here. I'm going to save this again to have the change with us. So click on cave tile map. Click on the tile we have here and start to draw. As you can see, there's a lot of space between here. So let's click on cell and change this to the size of your tile. Mine are 32 by 32. So if I now draw here, you can see that we have a nice auto tiling happening for us. Let's add the 45 degree tiles. So click here on the tile set again. Click on the image. Then click edit, and then on one of the arrows, just to make sure it pops into the right place. All right. This interface is a real pain to work with, so make sure you follow all of the instructions here. If something goes wrong and you set up a region wrong, it can end up really bad. So make sure that you follow along. All right. So now click on bit mask. Let's copy this bit mask. Now click on new auto tile. Then drag the whole area. Don't mess up here, because if you do, it could break things, okay? So make sure you get the whole tile set in one go. Okay, good. Now click on bit mask. And then click on paste bit mask. This should be 3x3 minimal as well. And as you can see, everything was laid out perfectly for us. So if it's set to 2x2, it's going to look a bit weird. But as soon as you click on 3x3 minimal, these things will come back. Now, what we have to do is replace this corner tile here with its slope tile over here. So we can just paint this in there and remove here. And the same with this tile here. It should be the slope tile. All right. So let's remove those and add them here instead. Okay, the tile we want to replace right now are these two down here. So if we remove this guy here, we want this guy instead. Remove this guy here and add him here instead. And click on save. Let's have a look what this looks like. Click on K map. get the tiles and draw here. As you can see, that looks pretty neat. Now we have one more problem. We have two different autotile sets. And if I try to draw with this one on top of the other, look what happens here. We are messing things up because they don't go well together right now. So let's fix this. So let's start by clicking here on tile set. As you can see, we have a script here that we can attach. This works perfectly fine with GDScript, but not with C# script. So if I click here, new C# script, it's like nothing's here. It just disappeared. There's no nothing. So click on cave tile map again, click on cave, and click on the undo button here. We have to create the script manually. Not if you're using GDScript, but if you're using C# script. So I'm gonna right click on tile sets, new script, and I will call this auto tile, and click create. Let's open the script. First of all, we have to make sure that this is a tool. Next, we need to change from node to tile set here so that we inherit from the right place. And tile set does not have a ready method, so we can delete everything in here right now. Next, we can right click on the tile set and go to the definition. And in here, if you type in is tile bound, you will find it down here. And what this method does is that it determines when the autotiler should consider two different autotile IDs to be bound together. So we will use this method right here. So copy everything from the bool to the end, right click, copy, go back to autotile, and type in public override and paste it in. Now the curly brackets. Right now we're not returning anything. That's why it's being a bit annoying with us. So in here, all we have to do is just type in return get tile IDs, and if they contain the neighbor ID. And this is all you have to do to make this work. So let's save this. Control S or file save, minimize. Now let's get back here and click on cave tile map and click on the tile set, click on script, click on load. Then choose the autotile script here. Click open. Now we have to save the scene as well. Scene, save scene, so we can use it again. Scenes, and we can call this cave tile map.tscn, save. Okay. Now let's try this out. Let's click on the tiles. And right now, as you can see, they merge perfectly fine together. Looks pretty neat, right? Let's fix this tile here to make it more easy to see what we are drawing. So click on the cave tile set again. Click on the image, click on edit, click on an arrow. Very important. If you don't, you can mess things up and this interface is really bad. But there's a new one coming in 4.0, so we have to wait for that. Now we selected the right one here. Let's click on the icon. Let's set the slope as the icon instead. Save this as well. So we click on tile map now. We now have a slope instead, so we know that we are drawing slopes. All right. Now let's add some 22.5 degree slopes as well. So click on the tile set, click on the image, click on edit, click on an arrow, then click on new auto tile. Now don't mess this up. Remember the region when you draw it, you have to make sure that you get it right at the first go or you will have problems. So make sure you get everything in one go here. Good. Now let's click on bit mask. Let's go back to the first one. Now let's click here on copy and go back to our new one and paste and change this from autotile bitmask 2x2 to 3x3 minimal, and we get all the things back. All right. Next, we want to set up the slopes. So what we will do first is to remove all of these guys up here. Then we will add one like so. And this one will be the corner tile. It's going to look like this. And now remove these guys down here. Like so, and click on save. Click on cave tile map. Let's find a new area here. Let's flesh something out quickly. And let's use the tiles here. Let's make the final slope. Click on the cave tile set. Click on the image. Click on edit. Click on one arrow. Let's find the old tile set here. This guy. Click on copy. Click on new auto tile. Don't mess this up. Draw the rectangle perfect the first time. And let go. Then click on bitmask and paste. Now just remove these two there and put them here instead. Click on the icon and set this guy to be the slope. Click on save. Let's go back. Cave tile map. We can now draw slopes in the other direction as well. We start by clicking two times. So a quick demo. You can use the tiles here easily. And also the 45 degree tiles is going to work perfectly fine as well. However, the 22.5 degree slopes are not perfect. But if you use them in the right way, it's going to be very easy for you. So let's click on the cave tiles here. And say you want to have a less steep slope. All you have to do is just click once and twice. Once and twice on the existing slope. And as you can see down here, it doesn't match up perfectly. No problem. Click once there and once there. And you have now built your slope. It's the same with the other side here. Grab the slope, make it less steep, like so. There you go. This is how you set up the autotile to work properly in the Godot engine. See you in the next session.